Hey everybody, it's Nick here from Grayscale Gorilla, and I'm really excited to show you a brand new plugin we've been working on called Gorilla Cam. We built Gorilla Cam to help you make more realistic and natural camera moves inside of Cinema 4D. Now remember, anytime during this video, just check down below if you want to learn more about Gorilla Cam. All right, let's head on into Cinema 4D and let's get started. All right, here we are in Cinema 4D, and let me show you what Gorilla Cam can do. Now, first of all, let's take a look at this scene before Gorilla Cam. If we hit play, you see we have a really simple camera move going from the back to the front of the scene. The keyframes are really robotic, and it looks like a computer-generated camera, because it is. We found ourselves in this position all the time. How can we add more natural camera movement in Cinema 4D in less time? That's why we created Gorilla Cam. Let me show you how easy it is to set up. First, select the camera you want to add Gorilla Cam to. Come up to your plugins menu and click on Gorilla Cam. You automatically get a brand new Gorilla Cam camera with the tag ready to go. Now, by default, you're going to see that the keyframes are much more smoothed out. In fact, you have this settings down here to change the smoothing and the overshoot of your camera. This automatically adds a lot more natural feeling to any camera you bring into Gorilla Cam. Now, let me show you my favorite part of Gorilla Cam, and that's the shake system. And right before we do, we have to decide what scale our scene is. Now, we have some nice presets here, and this just helps Gorilla Cam get calibrated to your scene. In this case, we have these small objects in our scene, so I'm going to click the coffee cup scale, and I think we'll be all set to go. Okay, now the shake system. This is really powerful. This allows you to add slow, medium, and fast position shake to your existing camera with just a few sliders. Already we have a much more natural feeling to this camera. Now this also works with rotation. You can come down here and add slow, medium, and fast rotation. Now, if you don't want to dial this in yourself, we also have this awesome button down here called I'm Feeling Lucky. I use this all the time. Just open up any scene you want to make better, put in a Gorilla Cam, and start clicking on this button right here, I'm Feeling Lucky. I'm going to click it once as the camera plays, and you basically click it until you get a camera you like. That's a little boring for me. I'm going to click it again. That's a little crazy for me, but that could work in other scenes. Let's try one more. That's getting pretty close. Now, there's a little bit too much high rotation here. Let me dial this down a little bit, and I'm going to turn up our slow position in rotation. And again, we're looking for that natural camera move. This is looking pretty good. Okay, let me show you next the jolt system. By the way, if you want to learn more about the shake or the jolt system, we're going to have more videos you can learn about Gorilla Cam down below. Definitely check those out. All right, the jolt system adds even more craziness to your camera. If you've ever watched an action film and you see those parts where you can kind of feel the camera being bumped into by maybe an actor, maybe the person that's holding the camera, you know, bumped into something or had to step over something large. Those things make those scenes feel natural. They make it feel like you're there. So this is what the jolt system does. You could turn up the intensity of your rotation and your position, and then you could set up an interval. What an interval does is basically say, hey, every 30 frames or so, I want you to really bump the camera. And this adds an even more secondary way for you to naturally add some really cool moves to your camera. Now, you can, of course, turn off the interval and just say, pick a frame. So let's say we want our camera to really get bumped in frame 50 or so. We could come up here and not in interval, in our custom trigger, you type in 50 and you now at frame 50 are going to get a strong jolt. Boom. Before we jump into a few of these other tabs, I wanted to show you our preset system. There are a ton of presets that ship with Gorilla Cam, anywhere from basic moves all the way up to cinematic and crazy action moves that you can add to any camera in Cinema 4D. You can even save your own preset. In fact, if you like the preset that you made or you found with the Getting Lucky button, you can come up here and click Save and save it for later. I'll call this Demo Nick. And now, at any time, I can recall this move or I could share it with friends as well. Okay, let me show you the zoom and focus features in Gorilla Cam. Inside the Zoom tab, you're going to see there's settings for input smoothing and overshoot. This is just another way that Gorilla Cam is smoothing out your existing animation, and not just position and rotation, but also zoom and focus, which we'll get to in a second. You can also add zoom drift, which is just another way to add variability and randomness to your current camera move. Now, this brings us to focus. Let's jump on into focus. Adding focus points to your scene is one of the best ways to draw attention to the things you want your audience to look at. Now, in this case, we have a focal point, which we animated to tell our camera which things we want the camera to focus on at different parts of this animation. You can see back here, we want the focus to be on these markers. And as we zoom up, we want the focus to be on this lens and also on this lens. Now, after all these wiggles and moves, we can still set our focus to be exactly where we want it. So let me show you where to set that up. In Gorilla Cam, go to focus and drag the object that you want Gorilla Cam to be focused on into your focus object. Now, that alone gives you a lot of power to set up the exact focus point of your scene. And as our camera moves around, those parts of the scene are going to be exactly in focus. Now, you can leave it there and leave everything super crystal sharp, or you can add drift to your focus as well. It's another way to add human natural movement to your Cinema 4D camera. Now, a little goes a long way, and we could set these, turn these up, and instantly get focus drift as well as zoom, position, and rotation. All of this together goes to create a much more beautiful, much more interesting to look at scene in Cinema 4D. In fact, let's see the before and after. Let's go on into our original camera and see that we have no movement, this very, very linear camera move, and nothing happening from the rest. That's before. Let's check out after we added Gorilla Cam. Turn on our Gorilla Cam, hit play. Now, our camera move is much more natural, much more visually interesting to look at, and has way more human emotion inside of it. All of this without taking away from the original camera move. Thanks again for watching, everybody. We have put so much work into this plugin, and we've also been using it behind the scenes on our own work. We just love how easy it is to use, and we think you'll like it too. Don't forget, you can check down below to learn more about Gorilla Cam. And once again, thanks again so much for watching, and we'll see you in another video really soon. Bye, everybody.